Okay, now, time for another trip down memory lane. So, Fern, what kind of sticks out for you from this year?
Well, there is, of course, the certain emotional reunion of the greatest man band on planet Earth.
What, Mum?
No.
Another level? M&A?
No.
Five.
I'll tell you what, let's have a look at this. It's July to December.
For you party people out there, this was the sound of the summer. From Magaluf to Margate, Yolanda B. Cool versus D-Cup had us dancing the nights away. As anyone lucky enough to be at tea in the park would tell you, Mumford & Sons cemented their place as one of the most exciting live bands of 2010 with their rip-roaring, soaring sound. And after months of speculation...
This was then 15 years ago. Now, Take That are back. They're reforming, this time with Robbie Williams. What a shame we never
listened. But first, Gary and Robbie publicly kissed and made up with their tongue-in-cheek video for their duet single, Shame. The song went to number two when it was released in October. Hey, people spend a lifetime this way. And it was soon followed by another number two for the full reformed lineup and their single, The Flood. After hooking up with Eminem earlier in the year to release one of the biggest selling songs of 2010, Uber pop star Rihanna was back in October with yet another number one single. We're not sure how she fitted it in, but the hardest working woman in showbiz bought us another number one single and a new album. The X Factor finalist released a cover of David Bowie's track In Aid of Help for Heroes. This month, we saw new Christmas singles from the Queen of Christmas, Mariah. And Coldplay, who were giving their only TV performance of the song right here, especially for you on Christmas Top of the Pops later on in the show.